The Adelaide Oval will be the host of the first ever day-night cricket test match on the 27th of November this year. It's an auspicious moment for cricket, and I think it's been a long time coming. But we're very excited about the prospects that this brings for cricket, both here in Australia and overseas. It's about making the game more accessible to our fans, and by bringing the game into a time zone where more of our fans can watch the game. At the moment, most cricket's played during hours when kids are either at school or parents are at work, and we're trying to make sure that we can bring them to the game and for them to experience all the exciting moments that only Test cricket can bring. Yeah, look, we looked at Adelaide, Hobart and Brisbane for this match. And Adelaide, because of the ground's a superb ground. We know the fans of Adelaide turn out in big numbers for Test match cricket. And it's also climatically ideal. So from the time, and also the perspective of the time in the series. It's the third match of the series. And that gives the New Zealand team and the Australian players time to get into the game before they play the first pink ball test match. Yeah, well, I think the pink ball has been 10 years in development, and it's been trialled in Sheffield Shield matches. And both teams will get plenty of pink ball practice in the middle at night before they play the first test match. With anything new, any innovation, there's always things that you will learn from this experience, but we're very confident that the ball is ready to go after this length of development. Yeah, I think players of both sides are pretty apprehensive about it. Anything that's new is that they'll be apprehensive about, as players were when we first went to day-night cricket match with ODIs in the 80s. So I think it's fair to assume that both teams when they go out to bat or field will be a little bit nervous, but that's natural.